Warning, this video contains horror imagery. Hi, I'm Kula. I was originally gonna make this video when this craze was really popular, but there's been a lot of stuff going on, so this project ended up on the back burner for longer than I'd like to admit. Also, yes, I know, I'm using a TDS, deal with it. I've been interested in creepy fourth wall breaks in games for a while now, so when Joey Perleone's Little Piracy is No Party video came along, I really liked it. That video spawned a whole buttload of other fake anti-piracy screens that I kind of have a pet peeve with, so I'd like to talk about some of them in this video with you all. Sound good? No? Well then click off already. Yes? Well, I hope you have a fun time with me. Let's analyze the original Mario Party DS Piracy is No Party video. I'll play the original video for you all here. Alright, so let's actually analyze it. The video is about 40 seconds long, with the first 10 seconds being devoted to actual gameplay, the other 30 being devoted to error screens and the actual supposed anti-piracy screen. It starts off with actual gameplay which transitions into actual real-looking error screens and then transitions into a real-looking anti-piracy screen. Notice how I keep mentioning real-looking and actual? Foreshadowing. Anyway, the pros here are what I just mentioned. Everything is paced super well, the additional time devoted to the anti-piracy screen gives time to recover from the shock value of destroy the game card. The gameplay is actual gameplay that looks real. If you look at the behind the scenes of the video you'll see that it actually is real in-game footage. The error screens, while I dislike the text, match the quality of the background footage, and the text is even synced to the beat of the music. Mostly everything about this video is something I like. Note that Mario Party DS does not have a real anti-piracy screen, this is all obviously faked. The idea of Mario Party DS having an anti-piracy screen does make sense when you consider that many other DS games had anti-piracy screens. The DS had no built-in piracy protection and because of that R4 cards were all the rage back then. Let's talk about a bad example. I'll play the clip for you. I played only a clip of it because the actual video is about 2.5 minutes long, which actually perfectly transitions into what I want to talk about right now, length. All of these videos are being hosted on YouTube, remember. In the case of this specific Mario Kart Wii video, most of it is devoted to starting the game and actually getting into the race. I don't like this approach because it feels like it spends most of the average viewer's short attention span getting the viewer to believe that this was real. Most of the time, in the description of the video, it says it was fake anyway. Additionally, for this video, a pro that immediately turns into a con is the fact that this actually uses the real Wii crash noise. The video is trying to imply that this all takes place in one complete session, but the fact that it hard crashes actually distracts from that idea. One personal grievance of mine is the fact that it uses the Wario apparition for its big hit, which I personally don't like the Wario apparition and think it's pretty half-baked of a creepypasta. The last thing I want to go over in this video is the ragdoll physics on Mario at the end. This is also very distracting from what the video was trying to get across, which was that this was real gameplay. In the end, I like the fake anti-piracy screens, but if you are going to try to convince me that this was real, at least actually try. Hi. I'm Kula, and I hope you liked the video. It was really fun putting it together. I don't do stuff like this often, but I like it when I get to. You don't have to subscribe, actually I'd recommend that you didn't if you only liked this video. Go check out my other stuff before you subscribe if you do subscribe. Good night.